Hey, tourist.
I want that. In return, you come to my palace. To my palace.
Hello, my name is Leo Lytel. I am 15 years old, and I'm single. I've been single, let's see here, pretty much my whole life. Pretty sure it's because I'm unemployed. I live at home with my parents, and I don't have a car. These are all big red flags. It's why I don't get much attention on Match.com. I do, however, have a lot of success on Tinder, where I am a buff 28-year-old Georgetown medical student with a Porsche and a trust fund. Now, I'm a teenager, so I'm in that awkward phase of life. I'm kind of a mutant creature, part adult, part child. But I look back on the early years of childhood fondly. You know, those good old memories, like when you get in the van and it turns out the man doesn't have any candy. Of course, nowadays, candy won't cut it. We're in the 21st century. You need something like free Wi-Fi to up the ante. That's really all a kid wants anymore, speaking from experience. And I want to thank my mom and dad for being so supportive of my comedy. My mom helps me book gigs, and my dad helps me write my material. So I like to think I'm pretty far along in the entertainment industry because I've got two things that a lot of people strive to have. I have a Jewish writer, and my agent is a girl I used to sleep with. Thank you. I'm Leo Lytel.
Well, it's great to be here. I'm that excited. I'm beside myself. Good evening, everyone. We're the Nelson twins. My name's Justin, and this is my identical twin sister, Sharon. Well, we should tell you a bit about ourselves. We come from a small country town in New South Wales called Walbundry, and we used to be apprentice bakers, which is a coincidence because we're inbred.
I nearly spit my tea.
Walbundry was a small town. It had one shop, one pub, and one prostitute. Mum found it pretty tough working three jobs. Our mum didn't even know she was having twins until she was 6 months pregnant, and our dad was even more surprised because he'd been in jail for 3 years. Being twins, we can send each other telepathic messages, but Telstra found out about it. And it's now included in our cat plan. It's really frustrating knowing what each other's thinking. We once played a game of rock, paper, scissors that lasted 3 years. I really hate going through airport security at the moment, but I love flying, because every time we catch a flight somewhere, I always sit at the front of the plane and he sits at the rear. Then I tell the gay flight attendant to meet me up the back in 5 minutes.
Don't worry, I know what you're thinking. Harry Potter's had a nasty Quidditch accident. Do you know what I can't stand? Sorry, let me re-emphasise. Do you know what I can't stand? Well, look on the bright side. I've never had to queue at Disneyland. Now, I'm just going to throw a disclaimer out there. If I do get too energetic, please stop me. I want to keep my benefits. otherwise, how would I heat the jacuzzi? I'm joking. It's a pool. I was at the cinema seeing the new James Bond film the other day, and it got me thinking, you know, maybe I would have liked to have had a go, you know, being James Bond, but obviously I'm a bit inhibited. Ah, Mr. Bond, I've been expecting you. No lift. But this isn't the first Britain's Got Talent event I've been to. I was actually at the live tour in Manchester, funnily enough, 2 years ago. And the staff, they couldn't have been more helpful, moving people out the way, getting us to a seat. And then when we finally got there, the view was just fantastic. And we sat down and my sister, she tapped me on the shoulder, turned round, and I'll never forget this as long as I live. She said, Jack, we are so lucky you're disabled. You cannot take her anywhere. Thank you very much. I've been Jack Carroll. Goodbye.
I'm the youngest in my family. I was always getting beaten up by the two oldest, Mom and Dad. And I used to get smacked around by these green berets that lived in our neighborhood. Some people call them Girl Scouts, whatever. The morning of my 16th birthday, my whole family tried to surprise me with a car, but they missed. And every Saturday morning in our neighborhood, we would have this huge water balloon fight. And every Friday night, I'd put mine in the freezer, so I'd win. And after that, all the mothers in the neighborhood would take turns spanking me. It was awesome. In high school, I got caught shoplifting once from a car dealership. It was a Buick. And my father said to me through the bars of the jail cell, because he was in the next cell, he said, "You're no son of mine," which hurt me, and it confused my mother. She was like, "Damn it, how did he know?" I was a bad kid. I would sneak over to my neighbor's house late at night, and I would bounce up and down on their trampoline. That was their daughter's name, Arlene. And that's my time, everybody. Thank you very much.
Wow.
I'm okay with my voice, but I still struggle with some things. Like I have the hardest time at a drive-thru. You know, cause you got to say the order fast, and you're talking through an intercom. It's like, I don't know why I work there. But, I want to get to where people start to use my voice as the voice of their GPS. it's like in 1,000 feet make a U-turn. Your destination is ahead of you on the right. You should the guy. I believe that you can turn anything into positive. That's why I'm here. But I've come along some people who don't think that. Like I did a show one time where a guy stood up and was like, "Hey, you can't just make fun of disabilities just 'cause you have one." I was like, well, did I stutter? thank you guys so much.
Welcome to the Global Got Talent YouTube channel. Click here to subscribe.